Bacterial vaginosis. Clear? We are going to next topic. Any doubts in this topic? Shall we proceed to next topic? After this topic, I'll give you a break. I can finish off it in 10 minutes. Maximize. Full. Is it an STD or not?
No.
Why?
No.
It is nothing but an alteration of the normal vaginal flora. So what is the normal vaginal flora? What does it secrete? What is the normal vaginal pH? What is the normal vaginal pH? Last class, not even 2 days before, I told you. 4.5, normal vaginal pH, 4.5, okay? In the reproductive age group, I am speaking about the reproductive age group. So, normal reproductive age group, the pH is 4.5. So, why the pH is, the vagina is acid? Because of lactic acid production. Which bacilli is producing? Dodalins bacilli. Either it is normal or abnormal. So, the presence of Dodalins bacilli is normal. So, the Dodalins bacilli is normal. It is going to secrete lactic acid. That's why the pH of vagina is 4.5. Help me. Okay, bacterial vaginosis. First thing, most common cause of the vaginitis. So, it is most common cause of vaginitis. Second thing, what is main thing happening? It is nothing but an alteration. Suppose what is happening in the GIT? If you take lot of antibiotics, what will happen? Normal bacilli will decrease. It will cause diarrhea. The same thing is happening. So, the normal bacilli will decrease and abnormal bacilli will increase. Normal bacilli is Dodalins bacilli. So, that is maintaining the acidity. That will decrease and other abnormal bacilli will increase. What are they? Prevotella, Gardnerella, Mobilancus species. Okay, these are all the species which they are going to increase. And there will be decrease in the lactobacillus species. Okay, that's why it is causing vaginitis and infection. What are all the specific features of bacterial vaginosis? What are all the specific features? What type of discharge it will produce? Smell? Fishy odor. The specific feature for bacterial vaginosis is fishy odor. So, the pH is maintained or not in bacterial vaginosis? pH is definitely altered. So, the pH will be greater than 4.5. Next thing, what do we call it? Criteria? Amsel's criteria. The criteria to diagnose a case of bacterial vaginosis, we categorize some criteria. So, that is called as Amsel's criteria. We will see in the next slide what is that Amsel's criteria. So, they produce grey white discharge and the specific thing is they have fishy odor. So, they have fishy odor and discharge is copious and more thing is it will be adherent to the vaginal wall. Even though the discharge is copious, it will be totally adherent and it will be producing fishy odor, the specific feature. Either itching is seen or not? No, bacterial vaginosis, no itching. Which infection causes itching? Candida. Next. Trichomonas. Trichomonas and Candida produces itching. So, how do you make a diagnosis? The specific feature is clue cells. So, once you make a smear, wet smear, we see some cells, abnormal cells. The cells are called as clue cells. Clue cells are seen in which infection? Bacterial vaginosis. What are clue cells? These clue cells are nothing but whatever the infected cells are, bacteria are there, they'll go and sit on the bacterial vaginal cells. So, they'll sit on the vaginal cells. Once you see the smear, all the bacteria will be sitting on the vaginal epithelial cells. So, it will give a stippled appearance. Okay, that is called as clue cell. Is it clear? So, other cell, what other abnormality is? There will be few lactobacilli should be there normally. But because in bacterial vaginosis, decreased lactobacilli, we see only few lactobacilli. So, this is the clue cell picture. See, all this is the vaginal epithelial cells. You can see, are able to see the stippled appearance here? Okay? So, on the vaginal epithelial cell, this bacteria will sit. So, finally giving a stippled appearance, mosaic appearance, something like a mosaic. So, what is Amsel's criteria, which was asked very frequently for you. So, first thing is discharge. The discharge will be thin homogeneous discharge. The positive whiff test. What is whiff test? Take some dis... 2 minutes, I put it. What is whiff test? Whiff test is nothing but... We take some discharge, whatever the discharge of the patient, we take discharge on a slide and pour some KOH. Once we pour that KOH, what is going? It gives fishy odor. That is called as whiff test. That is positive whiff test. Very important features of the bacterial vaginosis, frequently asked. So positive whiff test. Other thing is clue cells. The vaginal pH is greater than 4.5. So what are the four criteria? Anyone can tell me without seeing? Greater than 4.5. Next. So the pH should be greater than. Positive whiff test is gives fishy odor. This fishy odor, why? Because of this amine. These bacteria, they will release amino substances. So that's why the fishy odor is seen on addition of the KOH solution. So erythema of vagina is not seen. Where do we see total erythema? Total strawberry is seen in trichomoniasis, but total erythema, entire erythema is seen in gonorrhea infection. Totally, entire Bartholin glands, cervix, vagina, urethra, totally will be inflamed. It is seen in gonorrhea, the gonorrhea picture. What is the treatment? Drug of choice for bacterial vaginosis? Drug of choice for trichomonas? So, the bacterial vaginosis and trichomonas both are same. The answer is metronidazole. So, metronidazole is the drug of choice. Drug of choice for chlamydia? For gonorrhea? In pregnancy in chlamydia? In pregnancy in gonorrhea? The most diagnosed to test in chlamydia? PCR and nucleic acid amplification. Once again, I am repeating. PCR is nucleic acid amplification. Both are the same. There is no difference. So, if there is no PCR, but the answer is, one of the answer is nucleic acid amplification. The answer will be nucleic acid amplification. PCR is nothing but we are amplifying the nucleic acids. So, both are same. Okay? Fine. So, the metronidazole, the drug is 500 mg. We give it twice a day for 7 days. Metronidazole gel, either you can use it or clindamycin. So, but remember, the drug of choice is metronidazole. Even in pregnant, we can give metronidazole, but not in the early trimester. So, what we go is, we give betadine capsules, pervaginal capsules, okay? But not metronidazole in the early trimester, okay? It is contraindicated. Yeah, come on, answer it. Answer, A, B, C, D. Yeah, B. Next, coming to trichomonas infection. Trichomonas infection, is it sexually transmitted or not? Sexually transmitted. Trichomonas infection is transmitted. Is it a protozoa? Yes or not? Okay. What is chlamydia? Gram negative intracellular obligate can be even parasitic. What is gonorrhea? Gram negative diplococci. Okay. Intracellular or extracellular? Intracellular. Trichomonas? Protozoa. It is a protozoa. Trichomonas is a protozoa. Okay. Caused by? How many? Is there only one Trichomonas vaginalis or other Trichomonas? Others. What are they? Baccalis. Homnis. Okay. Main. The important thing is you need to remember is not only just transmitted through the sexual route. The main mode of transmission of this is through wet towels and other surfaces. So, if the infected patient is using the contaminated towels and all, if the patient, normal patient is using that, so the automatically the infection will get transmitted. So this is the one condition where the towels and all, they're transmitting the infection. Okay. Incubation period, normal, you know, that is 34 to 28 days. So this is the trichomonas. How many flagella? Anterior how many? Posterior how many? This you need to read in the microbiology, I don't know. Approximately 4 to 5 flagella are there, posterior 1 flagella is there. That is main responsible for motility. Why asked about flagella is, how do you diagnose trichomonas infection is, once you take a smear and see it under the microscope, it will be approximately the size of a leukocyte. But the trichomonas, it will be moving because of the flagella. That's how we diagnose trichomonas. So this is the trichomonas trophozoite parasite. So normally it undergoes which, how do, what is the division? Longitudinal binary fission, normally trichomonas, that's they'll teach you anyway in microbiology class and all. Okay, coming to gynec, the thing, main thing about here is erythema or the edema of the vulva and vagina total. That's how we call it as strawberry spots. So the strawberry spots are specific feature of the trichomonas. and the discharge will be yellow green. Yellow green discharge is seen only in trichomonas, remember. Okay, chlamydia and gonorrhea, which discharge? Chlamydia, gonorrhea, I showed pictures also. Grey white ane chupichindi. Em discharge ostundi? Mucopurulent discharge. I showed you pictures also. The penis from cervix. So it is mucopurulent discharge, chlamydia, gonorrhea. Okay, whereas in case of trichomonas, yellow. Yellow, the yellowish green discharge, it is specific for trichomonas infection. Whereas in a case of bacterial vaginosis, copious, why? Homogeneous discharge. Okay, fine. This trichomonas causes itching or not? So only two conditions with itching. One is candida, other is trichomonas. So diagnosis, how do you diagnose a trichomonas? I already told you, if you take a wet smear, we can see it is because it is flagellated, it will be mobile. So it will be moving. That's how we diagnose it. Vaginal pH. What, it should be altered or not? It should be altered or not? Definitely it should be altered, even in trichomonas vaginalis. And which organisms are seen in pap smear other than trichomonas? If you take a pap smear, what is pap smear? Where do we do pap smear? To diagnose. So to diagnose is carcinoma cervix patient. It is a diagnosis of carcinoma cervix. Screening test. It is not a diagnostic test. It is a screening test for carcinoma cervix. So where do we take the smear? At what site? Squamocolumnar junction. Okay. What are all the other things we see in pap smear other than carcinoma cervix? Other than that, what do we see? Trichomonas. So trichomonas infection is also seen. Other than trichomonas infection, what infection we are going to see in pap smear? Candida. Even candida is also seen. Candida and trichomonas are seen in the pap smear. Okay. Treatment. Treatment for trichomonas and bacterial vaginosis are same. What is the drug of choice? Metronidazole. That's it. Whether we have to treat both or not? Both. Why? Yesterday. Treat both. Okay. That's what I told you. First trimester of pregnancy, never give metronidazole. Okay. Go for betadine capsules, parvaginally. Okay, that's it. Answer fast. What is the drug of choice? Metronidazole. So it inhibits even urinary tract and it is most common during the childbearing age. Why? It is the sexually transmitted, most common in that age group. Okay, next. Coming to candida, the important things, most common infection seen in the diabetes patients, what is the most common infection? Most common infection seen in the antibiotic users, frequent antibiotic, most common infection seen in the pregnancy. Annitiki candida na? Pregnancy. How many of you want to go for candidas? A. B. Trichomonas. Most common infection seen in pregnancy is candida. Okay, even in pregnancy also it is candidal infection. Okay, even in HIV also it is candidal infection. So what is this candida? It is also sexually transmitted or not? Yes, it is also sexually transmitted. So it is, is it a normal inhabitant? Yes, it is a normal inhabitant in few percent of the patients. It is a normal inhabitant. So even it is found in the rectum and oral cavity also, not only just the genital area, it is seen even in the rectum. So once you see the HIV patient, there will be even rectal candidiasis also. Okay, oral candidiasis. So the normal site it is. So it can, so the most common infection, these are all the very important bits. So in HIV infection, diabetes mellitus, pregnancy, this is the most common infection which is seen. So what is the main characteristic symptom? Itching. The patient complains of itching only two diseases. What is that? Trichomonas or candida. So what the specific feature is? Curdy white discharge. If your question says curdy white discharge, blindly put candida. So the curdy white discharge is not seen in any condition. It is something like a curdy white discharge. Once you remove that curdy white discharge, it will be small specules. Like, so once you remove that discharge, what will be there? Small erythematous spots will be left out. So this is the typical picture of the candida. Curdy white discharge only seen in candidial infection, followed by, so once you remove that curdy white discharge, there will be erythema. Okay. Order is seen in which diseases? Fishy order, bacterial vaginosis, but this doesn't produce an order. Okay. Curdy white means blindly go for candidial vaginitis. Yes, answer. ABCD answer is why not atrophic vaginitis? Where do we see atrophic vaginitis in which group? Postmenopausal. The most common cause of vaginitis in postmenopausal age group is which infection? The most common cause of vaginitis in postmenopausal age group. No infection. It is because of alteration in the vaginal pH. Decreased hormones, decreased alteration in the vaginal pH. It is going to cause atrophic vaginitis, senile vaginitis, otherwise we call it as. So the most common cause of itching, okay, in the postmenopausal age group is no infection. It is only senile vaginitis. That's why we give what? Estrogen cream to replace the normal vaginal pH and all. So in atrophic vaginitis, the pH is altered definitely. Because menopause, the vaginal pH will be altered. Whereas in a trichomonas, it is altered or not? I have shown you, it is altered. In bacterial vaginosis, it is altered. Whereas candida, it is not altered because it is even sitting in the normal conditions also. Okay? Diagnosis, how do you diagnose? The medium for gonorrhea? Medium for candida? Saprolactone dextrose agar. Before going to that, put some KOH. What is this KOH will do? It will lyse all other cells. So whenever the hypha and buds are left out, we are able to see that. Okay? Even we can do culture. With what agar? Saprolactone dextrose agar. Otherwise, which medium? If SDA is not available. Channel undi aa perto. MTV. Next class, answer me tomorrow. My class tomorrow, answer me. What is the medium other than the SDA? If SDA is not there, what is the medium for candida? Okay. Treatment. What is the treatment for candida? Treatment for candida? Fluconazole. Azole group of drugs. Fluconazole. Antifungals. This is a fungi. So we are giving fluconazole as a treatment. Does this male partners may or may not be treated in this? It is not a compulsory. Okay. So the important points here are bacterial vaginosis, pH is altered or not? Whereas trichomonas? Whereas candida? Type of discharge. Don't see without seeing answer. What is the type of discharge in bacterial vaginosis? Trichomonas? Yellowish green is seen in trichomonas. Candida? Peak white, curdy white. Smear. What do we see in smear if we take bacterial vaginosis? Clue cells. Okay. Trichomonas? Morality. Whatever the protozoa is there, we are going to see. Trichomonas. Whereas in Candida? Buds and hyphae. Candidal. Okay. Clear? We'll take a break.